Hello students, welcome to YouTube channel of St. Wilfrid's College of Arts, Commerce and Science, Panvel. Today my lecture topic is cathodic reductions. Okay, in this lecture we are going to see about introduction, after that cathodic reductions of a compound, after that olefins, arenes and electrodimerization. In galvanic corrosion, the cathodic reduction generally consists of a reduction of a dissolved oxygen. Okay, let's go for introduction. In that, as I was talking about the corrosion. Corrosion is just like a single metal contact. Corrosion is therefore partially dependent on the rate at which oxygen can reach the metal surface from the bulk of the electrolyte. Okay. After that, in cathodic reaction, what happens? The reduction reaction which occur at the cathode, electrons are released by anodic reaction are consumed at a cathode surface. Unlike an anodic reaction, there is a decrease in valence state. After that, the Markov-Lamb deoxygenation. Deoxygenation means removal of an oxygen molecule. It's an organic chemistry reaction. If you are talking about deoxygenation, it's nothing but a reduction reaction, means removal of oxygen molecule. The Markov-Lamb reaction is a variant of a Boveri-Blanc reactions and an alternative to the classic Barton-MacCombe deoxygenation. It is named for the Belgian chemist Itzhak Markov and Kelvin Lamb. After that, let's move further with the cathodic reactions of a nitro compound. For that, first we need to know what is means of reduction. Okay, reduction is nothing but removal of oxygen atom and addition of a hydrogen atom. Okay, removal of oxygen atom and addition of hydrogen atom will take place. After that, this reaction always carried out at a cathode. If you are talking about a galvanic cell, then a reduction reaction always take place at a cathode and oxidation reaction take place at a anode. Okay, so let's start with this reaction. If you are able to see this reaction, this reactant is nothing but your nitrobenzene, right? Here we are going to add H plus atom and electron. H plus atom we are adding, that means this is a reduction reaction, that NO2 will convert it to NH2. Only that two oxygen atom is removed and addition of two hydrogen atom will take place. It is nothing but a reduction reaction in which oxygen will remove and addition of hydrogen will take place. So our reaction is like that. The nitrobenzene, after addition of hydrogen, or we can say that after reduction, it gives us a aniline compound. Okay, aniline is nothing but a benzene ring with amine compound. Okay, so our reactant is a nitrobenzene and product is a aniline. Okay, let's move further with its mechanism. If you are able to see, this one is our first reactant, which is a nitrobenzene. Okay, let's see here. Nitrogen possessing positive charge and oxygen is possessing negative charge. Why it is like that? Because nitrogen's valency is 3. It can bound to 3 bonds. But here it is bounded to 4 bonds. Okay. And in oxygen, oxygen's valency is 2. But it is bounded here to only 1 bond. Only because of there is a positive charge on nitrogen atom and there is a negative charge on an oxygen atom. Okay. Let's move further. We are adding H plus atom and electrons, right? So what happened? That H plus, this is H plus means proton, okay? Plus, this plus sign, this negative sign, okay? The negative sign of this oxygen means this oxygen atom, which is an electronegative. It will attract that proton toward itself. Why? Because always opposite charges attract each other. So H plus atom will be attracted by this oxygen atom and we will get OH molecule. Okay. As H plus is getting attracted toward it, this bond is shifted to the oxygen. The double bond is shifted to this oxygen and this oxygen will possess a negative charge like this. If you are able to see, this one is this oxygen. Okay. So this bond is shifted toward the oxygen. If you are able to see, the plus charge from the nitrogen is removed after reduction, means addition of one hydrogen molecule. Why? Because here its valency is completed. It has only 3 bonds. Okay. But this oxygen has only 1 bond. So it is possessing negative charge. Why? Because this bond is shifted toward the oxygen and this oxygen is getting negative charge. Okay. This one is your first step. After that, we are again adding electron pair. We are adding electron pair. The electron pair will be attracted by nitrogen atom. Who will attract it? This one is this nitrogen. Okay. So you can see that there is an electron pair on a nitrogen. Okay. After that, again, we are going to add a H plus molecule in that. Okay. So as we are adding H plus ions, what happens? That H plus is attracted by this oxygen molecule. Okay. As oxygen molecule attract this H plus ion, it is converted to H2O molecule. If you are able to see, here is minus sign. Minus sign indicate what? That H2O is a leaving group. What? H2O is a leaving this reaction. This bond is broken between nitrogen and oxygen. The bond broke, and after that H2O will remove. But how H2O remove? That oxygen attract this H plus ions. Okay, what happened? Oxygen is an electronegative atom, so it will attract this hydrogen, and as you can see, at it is attracting, that means it is preparing bond with him, it is making new bond with him, right? So this bond will break. Why? Because that oxygen will possess then three bonds and it will be unstable, right? So for being stable, it broke the bond between nitrogen and oxygen and it removed. After that, what happened? The electron pair from here, that oxygen, it will shifted to the nitrogen and oxygen double bond, and it will prepare a double bond. Okay, so this electron pair is removed. As oxygen is a your electronegative atom, what happened? It take away its electrons and it will remove with H2O, and this electron pair from oxygen atom is shifted in between the nitrogen, and we will get this type of compound, double bond O, N double bond O. Why? Because this electron pair is shifted in between both of them. Okay, after that we are adding two electron. What we are adding? Two electron pair we are adding. Let's see, we will get that two electron pair at here. The double bond is broke as we are adding electron, right? So the double bond is converted to single bond. Okay, let's see, after that we are again adding H plus molecule. In that H plus molecule we are adding, that means this oxygen which has a negative charge, right? After breaking that bond, that oxygen will possess a negative charge. Okay, that negative charge will attract this positive charge, so it will converted into hydroxy group. Means that hydrogen is attracted by this oxygen molecule. Okay, it attack to oxygen molecule, it prepare a new bond with hydrogen atom. So we will get this type of compound. After that, we are adding H plus ion again. Again, we are adding H plus ion. So what will happen? We will get this type of compound where that O will possess this H plus will attracted by this nitrogen atom. Who will attract them? It will attracted by that nitrogen atom. Okay, because you can see that nitrogen's valency is not completed here. Here there are only two bonds which nitrogen is attached. So the new hydrogen atom is attracted by this nitrogen atom. So finally we will get this type of compound. Okay, NHOH. After that, there are two possibilities. If we are adding weak acid and if we are adding strong acid, then okay, this one is our compound. If we are adding weak acid, then we will get NH2. Okay, if we are adding weak acid means H plus ions. We are adding acids means what we are adding? We are adding H plus ions. Okay, after addition of a weak acid, what will happen? That one H molecule will be absorbed by this nitrogen atom, and H2O will remove. Okay, let's see what happened at here. 2H molecule. 2H molecule will be added to this compound. Okay, this compound. What happened? One hydrogen will be taken by this nitrogen and second hydrogen will be taken by this oxygen. Okay, as oxygen has already one hydrogen atom, it is already and taking new hydrogen atom. So it will remove as a water molecule. It will break bond between oxygen and nitrogen, and it will remove as a water molecule. And next hydrogen, which is second hydrogen, it will be extracted by this nitrogen atom. So finally, we will get a compound which is a weak acid. Okay, NH2 we will get. Okay, next, let's see, with the strong acid, what happened with strong acid? Strong acid means what? Okay, here we need to know what is means of weak acid and what is means of strong acid. Strong acid are the chemicals or substances which are able to release their proton very easily. Okay, they will give their proton easily. Proton means H plus ions, and weak acids, they give it slowly. Okay, they cannot, we can say that they are giving their H plus ion partially. Okay, and only because of that, only they are giving NH2, only two hydrogen atoms and amine will form. In strong acid, there are H plus ions can be removed easily from acid. So we will get this type of compound, NH2 as well as the OH. That OH will again react with the pair position of this compound, and we will get this type of compound, which is nothing but an, we can call it as a one amino phenol, okay, or we can also called as a para amino phenol. Okay, so this this one is our reactions for nitro compounds, cathodic reduction at nitro compound. What will happen, that nitro compound NO2 group is finally converted to NH2 in presence of a weak acid. That means it is converted to anion. Okay, but in presence of a strong acid, we will get a substituted compound. Okay, not only NH2, but we will get a hydroxy compound at the para position. Okay, next let's see about the example. What happened in example? Again, we are adding weak acid. Weak acid will remove two to four hydrogens, right? So these nitro groups, will be converted to amino group. Again, oxygen will be removed from that nitro group, and addition of a two hydrogen will take place. Okay. After that, next let's see. Okay, these are the reactions of olefins and electrodimerization. Okay, first let's see reactions of olefins. Olefins means double bonded compound. Okay, let's see first compound, that is our reactant. We are taking 2 moles of ethene cyanide. Okay, after that we are adding 2 electron in that and 2 hydrogen molecule. Okay, we are adding 2 electron and 2 hydrogens. What will happen? There are two reactions. Okay, the two reactant, they will react with each other and form one hydrocarbon compound, right? They will form a coupling reaction, that CHCN, CHCN will react with each other. And finally, we will get this type of compound. What will be the name of this? There are 4 carbon atoms, so it is a butane. And at 1 and 4 position, there is a cyanide group. So we can say that 1,4 cyanide butane compound is it. Okay. After that, let's see the mechanism, what will happen. First, we are taking our reactant, okay, ethene cyanide. What we are doing, we are just adding 2 CH2, CHCN, okay. After that, we are adding 2 electron in that. After addition of 2 electron, what will happen, that 2 CH2CN. First, we are removing CN minus ion. Our CN minus ion will remove. We will get this type of compound, okay. After that, we are going for a dimerization reaction. Dimerization means what? The two same molecule, okay. After removal of this cyanide compound, two same molecule will attach with each other with that cyanide. Okay, what happened? That two compounds attach with each other, or it can we can say that they are forming a coupling reaction. They prepare a bond between 2 carbon atom, and we will get an hydrocarbon compound. Okay, finally we are adding H plus molecule in that. After addition of H plus molecule, we will get our final compound, that is 1,4 dicyanobutane. Next, we will move further with the example. Again, same type of reaction. We are just adding to another reactant. First one is our cyanide, that is ethene cyanide. We are adding ethyl acetoacetate compound in that. Okay, this double bond is possesses at EO. Okay, so finally we will get again coupling type of reaction, and we will get this product. Again, next, same, we are adding. Okay, yeah, here we are taking 2 moles of this compound. Again, we will get a coupling type of reaction. Let's move further for the cathodic reduction of arenes. Okay, what happen if we are going to do reduction at arenes? Let's see, first reactant. This one is our reactant. Okay, we are going to add 2H+ and 2 electrons. Okay. After addition of that, we will get this type of compound. Means that 2 hydrogens are removed, and oxidation will take place there. Here we are removing 2H+ atom. If you are able to see, we are removing 2H+ atom and 2 electrons, right? Addition of 2H+. Okay, these are the this one is a reversible reaction. We can say that if we go from this direction to this direction, it will be an oxidation reaction. Okay, but if we go for this type of reaction if we consider this one is our reactant and this one is our product, that means this one is your reduction reaction. Okay, but if we consider this one is our reactant and this one is our product, then it is an oxidation reaction. Only removal of hydrogen is take place when we are moving to the oxidation reaction. Okay, OH is converted to O, means that is oxidation reaction. Okay, and that C double bond O is converted to OH, that means it is an reduction reaction. Okay, let's see for the mechanism. first we are taking us our first reactant. In that we are going to add one electron. After addition of one electron and H plus ion, what will happen? That electron will be attracted by this oxygen atoms. Okay, the electron we are adding, that it will be attracted by the oxygen atom. After that we are adding H plus ion in that. Okay, so that H plus ion will be attracted this oxygen, and this bond is shifted toward here, and only because of that we will get one electron at this position. This carbon will possess that one electron. It is something like a free radical. Okay, after that what happened? The bond will be shifted toward here, and this bond this bond will be shifted toward here just for to stabilize this carbon atom, and we will find this type of compound. Okay, after that what will happen? The electron pair at here, only resonance is taking place at here. Okay, resonating structures we are seeing. So this electron pair shift here, and because of that this bond will be shift here. That because of that we will get that oxygen with a negative charge. After that we are adding H plus molecule in that, so that H plus molecule will be abstracted or attracted by this negatively charged oxygen atom, and they will prepare one bond between them. So we will finally get an hydroxy type of compound. Okay, what happen is just nothing but an resonating structure, we can say as a canonical structure. After resonance we will get OH at both side, that C double bond O carbonyl group is converted to alcoholic group, that is CHOH. Okay, after that these are some reactions. After addition of two E electron, what will happen? The bond between these two the bond between the double bond of this middle ring will be reduced, and we will get this type of compound again here. Okay, again if we add next compound in that, that is acetyl chloride, then what will happen? That two acetyl chloride will attack on this carbon atom. As we know that in anthracene, this position 9 and 10 carbon are the most reactive places. All the reaction will take place on this position. So this acetyl chloride will react with this, that position. Okay, thank you.